I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Brad Patterson. I'm the director of marketing and new business, but my favorite way to introduce myself is, hi, my name's Brad. I'm an alcoholic. We're here today because in the world of treatment, there is this incredible risk that treatment providers face every single day in that we have to discharge you. At day 31, or longer for some, you're going to graduate from here and go back to real life. And so what we did is we've been looking for the 39 years that Keystone has been serving clients such as yourselves at how we can make sure that you never have to come back here, except maybe to talk at an AA or NA or GA meeting. We know that the challenge is huge. And so what I did is I put together a talk about how to make the most of your first year in recovery. This is going to be a little bit redundant. I don't want you to be insulted by that. One of the classic things that happens to people when they get away from the treatment center safety is that they forget everything. And this is, again, not an insult. It is the standard nature of addiction. You have demons roaring to get you back. Your addiction is cunning, baffling, powerful, and patient. And the thing that we want to do is give you every single good tool and instruction that will help you to be a success at the end of your first year of recovery. The reason why I have passion, true passion for this, is that I came in really, really smart to treatment. I had degrees and all of this potential and crap, and I was a hopeless gutter drunk. No matter how much knowledge I had come in with, I didn't know what the future held. I didn't know what directions I was going to take. And it was a very good thing that I really did hit a rock bottom, because effectively I just put the wax from my ears and my mouth and I just started to listen for the first time in my life. The instructions we're going to give you today are proven and proven and proven. And you guys may know this quote that I'm about to share, but rarely have we seen a person fail who has thoroughly followed our path. At the end of his life, Bill Wilson, who wrote those words, was asked if he would have changed any of the original instructions in the first 164 pages. These 164 pages have stemmed 180 different 12-step recovery programs. He said, I would have changed one word in the entire 164 pages. We would have changed rarely to never. I'm telling you words, guys, that will guarantee your success, but only if you follow them. And I'm sharing this because the risk is huge. You don't know how good it's going to be. I promise you that. You don't know how much is out there for you. But the addiction that you came in because of is still waiting, haunting, roaring. And all you have to do is let your guard down, get a little arrogant, tell yourself you can do it yourself, and you're going to be a statistic. And we don't want to see any of you become a statistic. Let me give you the actual numbers. You are at a very special place, a very special place. Nationwide, if you're a defiant treatment attender, somebody who's just there because the courts have ordered it, okay, and you're just going to basically do your 30 days and get off paper. The likelihood of long-term recovery with that attitude in that circumstance is 10%. Even with our defiant clients, we see about a 30% likelihood of long-term recovery at Keystone. So maybe the defiant client decides to go to some aftercare or outpatient post-treatment programming. That client, on a nationwide scale, has about a 30% chance of success, just getting a little help after treatment. At Keystone, that bumps you up to about 50%. If by chance, nationwide, you defiantly attend treatment, you'll go to a little bit of aftercare and maybe see a few of those AA meetings or NA meetings. Nationwide, the statistic is about 50%. At Keystone, we get you up to 93%. You're in a very special place. That's 9 out of 10 potential success. I'd like to see it be 100% because I don't want to lose any of you. I know what it was like when I was at my bottom. I don't want any of you to go back there. So the reason why I am passionate is that this is a life or death journey. The most important time period is your first year. We're going to talk about some tools. We're going to talk about some basic behavioral practices that you're going to have to implement. There are no excuses. I'm going to give you this phrase, no matter what, do what you're suggested to do. No matter what. That's the way recovery works. We work recovery no matter what. If you are willing to go to any lengths, then you're going to have a no matter what attitude. No matter what, we're going to get to a meeting. No matter what, we're going to get online. We're going to get engaged. We're going to work our steps. We're going to get a sponsor. These are the kind of things that are ensuring your success. And again, I don't want you to feel insulted by this. This has been what we've seen to work over decades and decades. Excuse me. So, I'm just going to go ahead and march through this little suggested recipe for success. The way that it works is you don't have to do anything today. There is a slot next to each of the described items. When you achieve these, put a date in there. And so you have a document that will be chronologically showing your progress. It's a great tool about month 6 or 7 when you're thinking, this is for the birds. I'm tired of this. I don't like doing this. But when you look back and you say, this is how I achieved 6 months, it can give you a little inspiration to just keep marching forward. I'm going to give you the warning, guys. They don't tell you this. You're going to face a relapse window between about months 3 and about months 9. The world is going to fall apart. The person that you fell in love with in week 6 is going to break up with you in month 6. You're going to have problems at work. You're going to have problems with family. This happens to all of us during the first year of recovery. You need to be prepared for it, and the only way you can be prepared for it is to fortify yourself with all the recovery tools you can find. I want you to be forewarned. The relapse window will come. The fact is, there are resources to protect you from this time. Making it to the year gives you a likelihood of long-term recovery that is something like 20 times better than day 31. You make it to the year, you've actually achieved a foundation. Now, you can't just half-ass it. Half measures avail us nothing. You guys know the words. We got to give this our best. So I'm going to give you these instructions, and again, they're going to sound redundant, but effectively, it is that kind of repetition that will help to change our addiction's influence. So day one, this is day 31, guys. You've packed up, you've checked out, you've had everybody sign your books, you're heading home, wherever home is. Maybe it's a halfway house. Maybe it's back to the neighborhood. The very first thing you do, guys, unpack your stuff and get to a meeting. I promise you, everything else will wait. Everything else will wait. Unpack your stuff, get to a meeting. It's that simple. And when you've done that, put the date in there that you did it. This is a great beginning. The first week, we're going to try to get to 5 to 7 meetings of recovery. Drawback is, guys, I know a lot of you have got rural distances. We're going to talk about an online resource for the first time that we can honor or offer as a trustworthy resource. So if you can only get to 1 or 2 meetings a week because of your rural circumstance, you can get to 4 to 5 meetings online. And you can supplement that so you're in daily connection. It's really important. If you have the access to get to face-to-face meetings, the online opportunity cannot substitute for that. It's only really to be used as a substitute for those people who don't have any other resource. But finally, we do have resources. For so long, people in rural circumstances would get back home and they'd be 100 miles from a meeting. And they wouldn't be able to get to that first meeting. So today they can log on and we can basically hook you up. At the end of this talk, we're actually going to be signing up. And because of schedules, guys, we have to have the men first and then the women second, because the men have actually a 9:30 event. So we will sign the men up first, and then the ladies, you'll just form a line here, and we'll just sign up as many. All you need is an active email account. There's no charge whatsoever. Keystone's taking care of this, and we want you to be engaged. So as many people that we can sign up today, we'll do. But ladies, please let the men go first, because they've got a 9:30 meeting in the lecture hall, and the ladies have a 10 o'clock in Fireside. So we'll try to get it all taken care of. First week, guys, 5 to 7 meetings. Why is that? Even if you're not a daily drinker, you need a daily change of behavior. And the bottom line is that we see people who get into daily meetings more likely to succeed. During my first 6 months, went to 221 meetings. That's more than a meeting a day for 6 months. The 90 meetings in 90 days is a great foundation, but why not keep it up? It just takes about an hour, hour and a half, even if you have to travel maybe two and a half hours. You can do this. One meeting a day is not going to kill you, especially if you are drinking 8 to 12 hours a day. This is just a couple of hours. Very functional, spiritual. It's going to basically begin your solid recovery. We want you to log in that first week to the One Recovery that we're going to sign you up today. They actually just changed their name last week. It's now called One Health, because it actually is a tool for other types of recovery, and they wanted to make sure that all people were welcome. But our section, the Keystone section, is all about recovery from addiction. So we have our kind of our own little zone, and you'll enjoy that. I'll show you a little bit more in a bit. During the first week, guys, you need to connect with your outpatient or aftercare provider. And I'm going to give you this expectation. If you can achieve mental health or aftercare programming that is about a year or more long, it will help you to get through your first year. Don't look at this as an obligation. Look at this as a supportive resource. Just like your AA meetings, an aftercare post-treatment program is going to be one of those resources that can come to help you when the going gets tough. So get engaged with whatever level of post-treatment care is recommended. Mental health is another support. If you need that mental health support, establish a weekly or bi-weekly commitment to a counselor. Get that started your first week. It's a great foundation. Remember to finish your days with a spirit of thankfulness and gratitude. Take it easy, and the first day of recoveries can be intense. So let's march on to the first month. One meeting each day, and then begin working with your sponsor. Guys, I need to give you this because it's one of the things that always gets mixed up. A sponsor is not your friend who's not in recovery, but they're really nice. A sponsor is not a girlfriend. A sponsor is not a mom, dad, or uncle who's in recovery. A sponsor is a person who's worked all 12 steps in order and successfully give it away to other people. You want to get somebody who is a great guide. If I sent you off to Everest, you would not just go marching up the mountain. You would die. The fact is that what you would want if you went to Everest is to find the best guide you could afford. The best guide that had been up it, has know the route, know the pitfalls, and could guide you successfully through this difficult journey. That's what a sponsor is. You're looking for somebody who is a talented guide, not somebody who's going to be really cool to have coffee with. Somebody who can guide you through the 12 steps. That's what you need to find. Don't get distracted by all the things your head will say. Oh man, they dress so nice. Let's just go. They've got such a nice car. I just want to hang out with them. That's not a sponsor. Guys, this is a transformation and it's a journey. And you need to have a guide. So get yourself a sponsor that fills those needs and you'll be successful. Just to let you know, guys, I'm meeting with my sponsor tomorrow. I've met with him for the last 14 years once a week, and I'm still meeting with my sponsor. The fact is we don't ever graduate. We're never sane enough. That's what we continue in recovery, is that there's always more sanity to gain. So Can you, with your treatment plan, you'll now be engaged in aftercare. You'll hopefully be addressing mental health concerns as needed. The best part, guys, is at the end of 30 days, you get to get a 30-day chip. Now, technically, if you've been successful in being sober through your time in Keystone, you qualify for 30 days as soon as you get out. However you want to measure your time, it's fine. But take that 30-day chip. Take it. And remember that we're always, 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 whether it's 1 month, 2 months, 6 months, or a year, we take our chips for the newcomer. We don't take them because we're so cool. Oh, I got 30 days, aren't I special? That's not what recovery is about. It's, I'm very thankful for this opportunity. Things are changing slowly. I really want to encourage the newcomer to keep it up. Talk to a newcomer that night. Anytime you take a chip, it's about the newcomer. Remember that. It's a privilege to do it, and it's something that you really need to take advantage of. So celebrate the 30 days. You will have earned it by the time you graduate. Get that chip in a meeting, and remember that you can encourage a newcomer at that time. So let's see if we can march forward. 3 months. You see, here's where it gets redundant, guys. Meetings online, 3 times a week. 12-step, once a day. The nice thing about the online meetings is you can do it any time. So if you're basically just wanting to log on for 15 or 20 minutes before you go to bed, it's a great thing. Encourage people. Find friends. Connect with people from the group here. The reality is that there is going to be a way to just really enjoy this online community. This One Recovery is completely private, completely anonymous. And they actually have monitors. If there's any monkey business, like people trying to hook up online, they'll actually ask you not to participate. So please, guys, don't make that mistake. It is 100% anonymous, 100% private, 100% protected, all invitation. Nobody gets on unless they're invited, and they have to go through me to get there. So the bottom line is you guys have this resource. Use it. Use it. Make it a part of your recovery tool. Do it 3 times a week. If you're residing in a halfway house, you're probably about ready to move to the next level, which might be another level of structured care, but it also might be a move home. That's a big deal. When you are making that transition, make sure you are wrapped in recovery resources. Make sure you're engaged with your sponsor. You've got some recovery friends that are helping with this. Sometimes going home is the hardest thing. I had to spend 4 months in a halfway house, and it was pretty comfortable. I hated the beginning, but you know, about month 3 and 4, when I actually moved out, it was a little jittery. I remember going to the grocery store for the first time, and it was like, oh my gosh, this is where I used to get my stuff. And I got my sponsor to come with me to the grocery store that first time. That's what we do. We have to ask for help. Get that 90-day chip. 3 months is a big deal, guys. And remember, we do it for the newcomer. 6 months, we're striving for one 12-step meeting each day. We will have achieved 180 meetings in 180 days. That's a pretty good claim. Continue to participate in the One Recovery, One Health online discussions. Continue your treatment plan engagement. Sadly enough, guys, nationwide, most aftercare programs end after 6 months. If by chance that's your case, find something else to supplement that place. Find perhaps a community organization you can get involved with that would be understanding. Perhaps it's an organization through your church. Get continued help through that first year. Anything you can engage in is going to be really important to that lasting recovery. By this time, the employment instability will start to change. Oftentimes, the sickness in our mind will basically say, okay, I got to blow something up because I'm 6 months sober and I'm 6 months employed and this doesn't feel normal or comfortable. So we just blow up the company we work for, or we cause some sort of massive controversy. Guys, don't do that. Try to just do the next right thing. Keep it simple. Working is a drag most of the time. That's why they call it work. Just work. Just make it a one day at a time thing. Try not to be a part of the problem. Try to be a part of the solution. And please know that during that relapse window, classic challenges at work come up. So you got to be prepared for those things. If you keep it even, you're going to have a more likely chance of success. Make sure to get your 6 month chip for successful recovery, guys. And remember, we do this for the newcomer. Finally, the punchline of the whole thing. Continue everything from the above recommendations that works. That's what recovery is, guys. It's changing everything and doing it over and over and over. When we change everything from where we were, we have a much greater chance of success. That's what it's going to take. It's going to basically take changing everything. And we don't say that clear enough. It is going to take changing everything. Now, you don't have to do it all day 31. It's a one day at a time thing. And the best part about my higher power, and I hope he's your higher power, is that he never expects more from me than I can do in a day. He's not going to expect more from you than you can do in a day. And so what we want you to do to get through that first year is everything that works again and again and again and again. I'm going to read a couple more paragraphs. If you are successful at following these suggestions, you will have attended more than 212 step meetings and should be close to finishing your work through the 12 steps. You may be sponsoring others in early recovery. If this has not yet happened, you will be of remarkable value for those just beginning their journey very shortly. Many get concerned that they're not ready to give away the 12 steps when they approach their first year. But if you have been diligent about your own work, you will be the best person to share a story of strength, hope, and experience. Many distractions will come up during your first year. They may threaten relapse. If these distractions are allowed to take hold, there will be issues with relationships or lack of relationships, issues with friends and family, issues at work, possible issues with legal difficulties, and most certainly of thinking that you will not need any further help with your recovery. Deal with all of these with the help of counselors, groups, sponsors, online recovery friends, and the fellowship. You don't ever have to be alone again if you choose to remain invested in your own recovery. If you can simply put one foot in front of the other and repeat this for 365 days, you will be able to celebrate a remarkable achievement. Keystone will be there with you as you venture forward to your true beginning of freedom. So, close with this, guys. I'm really serious that I don't want to lose a single one of you. But the fundamental persistent nature of addiction is that people are not going to do what's been suggested. We are going to lose. And this is why we have to continue, all of us, to share this message that this works. It works because we're doing these things. And if you want the success that we've enjoyed, you got to do what we've done. I know it seems challenging. I know it is a big challenge, this first year of recovery. Guys, one day at a time. I woke up this morning at 5:30. That's when my sobriety began today. I hope to get to bed before midnight. That will be when my sobriety is, I can truly surrender it. And then we'll look tomorrow to basically see what we can do. One day at a time, guys. That's all that I'm challenging you to do. And if you do it well, one day at a time, you're going to make it just wonderfully through the first year.